Okay, see here.
Today we are going to see our next point, that is SSS condition, that is side condition. Okay. So statement is given, that is theorem number 9 is given. Okay, with the help of this we are going to prove SSS condition. Okay, but directly here now we are not going to use this. First we will use other criteria which we have learned. Okay, with the help of those criteria we are going to prove the theorem of SSS condition. Okay, so see here, statement is given, that is theorem number 9 is given. Two triangles are congruent if the three sides of one triangle are equal to the corresponding three sides of the other triangle. Okay, here see, two triangles are given, triangle ABC and triangle DEF. Okay, in that what is given, AB is equals to DE, then BC is equals to EF and AC is equals to DF. These three things are given, okay, which we can see from the figure. So that I am taking here now. What is given in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, what is given, AB is equals to DE, then BC is equals to EF, and third thing is given, AC is equal to DF. Okay, so three sides of this triangle ABC are equal to the three sides, corresponding sides of triangle DEF. Okay, so this is given. Now what we have to prove here, two triangles are congruent means we have to prove triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF. Okay, this we have to prove, this is our target. According to this we will think about the solution or proof. Okay, so now see here, in the current situation, if you will see here both the figures, if you will observe, then directly we cannot use any criteria. Okay, because here only three sides of one triangle are equal to the corresponding three sides of another triangle, that much only it is given. So directly we cannot use SAS or AAS. Okay, because we need at least one side in that, but here at least one angle, but here only sides are given. So to for the proof of this theorem we need to do some construction. Okay, so what construction we are going to do, see here, we are, this is BC is the longest side of the triangle, BC is the longest side of the triangle, and BC is equal to the EF, BC is equal to the EF. So what we are going to do, we are going to construct angle FEG. Here we will take, this is E point. Okay, here we will take G. Okay, we are going to construct FEG which is equal to the angle ABC, which is equal to the angle ABC. So this and this, okay, according to this we are doing construction. Okay, why these two angles, angle FEG and ABC are equal, by construction, accordingly that way only we are doing here construction. Okay, so now once you will do here construction, and one more thing we need to do, that is AB is equals to EG. Okay, whatever length of AB, that much length we will use for the EG. Okay, so two things we have, what we have done construction, AB is equals to EG and angle ABC is equal to FEG. So like that construction we have done. Okay, so after construction what we can do, we can join this with point D. Okay, we can join with the point G, we will join with D and also with F. Okay, so see here, construction we need to mention here, that is construction, what we have to do, construct angle FEG, construct angle FEG which is equal to the, which is equal to angle ABC, which is equal to the angle FEG. This angle and this angle is equal. Okay, like that construction we have done. Then one, AB is equal to EG. EB is equal to EG. Okay, so like that construction we have done. Okay, so now if I am thinking about triangle ABC, triangle ABC and triangle EGF, okay, triangle ABC and EGF, we are thinking about these two triangles. So which things are same here? See here, AB is equals to EG. AB is equal to EG. Why? By construction. Then angle ABC is equals to angle FEG. Just now we have done. That is also by construction. And third thing is BC is equals to EF. BC is equals to EF, which is given. BC is equals to EF. That is given. So three things we have. That is side, angle and side. So by SAS criteria, we can show triangle ABC and EFG are congruent. Okay, so that thing we are going to do first. Okay, so see here, in proof, triangle ABC, in triangle ABC and triangle ABC and triangle FEG, triangle FEG, AB is equals to EG, AB is equal to EG, that is by construction. By construction, AB is equals to EG, that is by construction. Then second, angle ABC, angle ABC is equal to FEG, angle FEG, that is also by construction. Accordingly, we have done construction. Okay. And third thing, BC is equals to EF, BC is equal to EF, that is given. Okay, so side, angle and side. By side, angle, side, we can say triangle ABC congruent triangle D, ABC congruent FEG, FEG by SAS, side, angle, side. Okay, now what we have done here, triangle ABC and triangle FEG are congruent. Okay, if both the triangles are congruent, both the triangles are congruent, can we say angle A and angle G are equal? Okay, because by CPCT we can say angle A and angle G are equal. Also we can say AC and FG are equal. AC and FG are equal. So that I am saying here, triangle, here I am taking that angle. So angle A is equal to angle G, and second thing we can say AC is equal to FG. FG, this is I am saying first one, this is I am saying second one, and both the regions are CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, angle A and angle G are equal, AC is equal to FG. So here we can give here three lines. Okay, still we have not thought about triangle DEF. Okay, we are thinking about triangle ABC and triangle FEG. We are thinking about these two triangles. Okay, so now by CPCT, angle A is equal to angle G and angle AC is equal to FG. AC is equal to FG. Okay, now see here carefully, what is given? AB is equal to EG, that we have done construction. Okay, so AB is equal to EG. Okay, but AB is equal to DE, this construction we have done, but AB is equal to DE, that is given, AB is equal to DE, that is given, understood? So can we say DE is equal to EG? Okay, we can say with the help of this, we can say DE is equal to GE. So this is I am saying third one, DE is equal to GE. Okay, if DE and GE are equal, then DEG is an isosceles triangle, so definitely angle EDG, angle, this angle will be same. If this is an isosceles triangle, base angle, these are the base angles now. So EDG, angle EDG is equal to EGD, angle EGD, okay, EDG is equal to EGD. Why? because these two sides are equal. Okay, if sides are equal, opposite angles are equal. So here we can give angles opposite of equal sides. Opposite of equal sides. Okay, angles opposite of equal sides. Okay, so now these two angles are equal. So I am saying this is fourth one. This I am saying here fourth one. Okay, as same as here, what is given? See, AC is equal to GF. AC is equal to GF or FG. So I am taking that AC is equal to FG. AC and FG is equal. But what is given? AC is equal to DF. AC is equal to DF. That is given. AC is equal to DF. That is given thing. Okay. If AC is equal to FG, AC is equal to DF. So can I say here FG and DF are congruent? Okay. So that I am saying here now FG is equal to DF. So this is fourth and this is I am saying fifth one. Okay. So now FG and DF. FG and DF are congruent. So again here FDG is an isosceles triangle. If this is an isosceles triangle, so definitely we can say FDG is equal to FGD. Okay. So this is I am saying here FDG angle FDG. FDG is equals to FGD angle FGD. This is sixth one. What is the reason? Angles opposite of equal sides. Angles opposite of equal sides. Okay. So this, with the help of this reason, we can say these two angles are equal. Okay. So now after this is sixth one. And this is fourth one. Okay. So now see here carefully. If this fourth one and sixth one, if you will take together, what is given? See EDG. EDG and here FDG. FDG. Okay. Here what is given? EDG. EDG means this angle. Okay. And here LHS FDG. FDG means what? FDG. So this angle. Okay. If you will add them, then I will get angle D. As same as when you will add RHS, that they will get angle G. Okay. See how that will work. See carefully. By adding this, that is fourth one, fourth and sixth. Okay, so by adding means we will add LHS in LHS, RHS in RHS. Okay, so EDG, angle EDG plus EDG plus angle FDG plus angle FDG is equal to EGD, angle EGD plus angle EGD plus FGD plus angle FGD. Okay. Now see carefully EDG plus FDG. EDG plus FDG means, in short, we are adding this plus this. So we can say EDF or angle D also we can say. The sum of this is angle D, or we can say EDF. Okay. As well as here in RHS EGD. EGD means this angle plus FGD means the sum of these two angles. Sum of this and this angle. So we can say EGF. So that directly I can say angle G. Directly I can say angle G. So this is our seventh one. This is I am saying here seventh. Okay. Now what I got here? Angle D and angle G are equal. That proof we have given. Okay. Actually, what is our target? We have to prove triangle ABC and triangle DEF are congruent. Okay. Triangle ABC and triangle DEF are congruent. That is our target, that we are going to prove. But now here we got angle D and angle G are equal. Angle D and angle G are equal. But here we have given proof angle A and angle G are equal. Angle A and angle G are equal. Okay. So here we can say angle A is equal to angle G by from one angle A is equal to angle G, but angle G is equals to angle D. So can I say angle A and D are equal? Okay. So angle A is equal to angle D. So this angle, now we got this angle and this angle is equal. Okay, so here this is one thing I got, that is I am saying here this is 81. Okay, angle A equals to angle D. AB is given ED, this is 81. Okay, now we will think about triangle ABC. Now in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, triangle DEF, what we can say? AB is equals to ED, AB is equals to ED, which is given. Okay, this is given. Then BAC is equals to EDF, angle BAC is equals to angle EDF, or directly we can take angle A is equal to angle D. Okay, from 8, here we can give from 8. Okay, and last one, AC is equals to DF, angle, sorry, side AC is equals to side DF. AC and DF are equal. Okay, what is the reason? It is also given. Okay, now here we can see that this is side, angle and side. By SAS criteria, triangle ABC and triangle DEF are congruent. Okay, so finally we can write here triangle ABC, triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF by SAS criteria, by side, angle, side. Okay, so when three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of corresponding triangle, that time both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so this new condition we have learned today, we will see some examples depend on this. Okay, so once again see carefully what was given. Statement was given and two figures were given. Okay, so now ABC means three sides of triangle ABC and three sides of triangle DEF are equal, that was given. With the help of this, directly we cannot prove, so we have done some construction. Okay, we have done this angle FEG equals to angle ABC. Okay, then AB and EG we have constructed of equal length. Then AB is equal to EG, this angle and this angle is equal, BC and EF are equal, which is given. So by SAS criteria we have given here proof, this and this triangle is congruent. Okay, then what we said here, we have given here proof for these two angles are equal. Okay, if these two angles are equal, we have made here one statement, this is EDG equals to GED and again FDG equals to, and by adding both we got this angle D equals to angle G. But we said here angle A and angle G are equal, that proof here we have given. If A is equal to G and G is equal to D, then directly we can say angle A is equal to D. Okay, so that only we said here. And then side, angle, side, side, angle, side, by SAS criteria both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so this is very important theorem. See carefully and solve this again in your notebook. Okay, see here our first problem, which is depend on the SSS condition, that is in figure it is given that AB is equal to CD, AB and CD are equal, this is, these two sides are equal, AD is equal to BC, means this AD and BC are same, this and this are same. Then we have to prove triangle ADC and triangle CBA are congruent. Okay, so we will take that directly here. In triangle ADC and triangle CBA, two triangles we have taken. Okay, so now here what is given? CD, what is given? First thing, AB is equal to CD, AB and CD are equal, AB and CD are equal in both the triangles. This is, CD is the side of triangle ADC and AB is the side of triangle CBA, means corresponding triangles, and that one side is equal. So we can say AB is equals to CD. This is given. This is given thing. One more thing they have told us, AD is equals to BC. Okay, AD is the side of triangle ADC and BC is the side of triangle CBA. and both the sides are corresponding sides are equal. And third thing we can take here, AC is equal to AC because both the triangles are standing on the base AC. So obviously that is equal. So we can say that is AC is equal to AC, okay, which is common base for both the triangles. That is enough. So we can say directly here by SSS, side criteria, both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so here finally we can write triangle ADC congruent triangle CBA by SSS. Very simple example. Okay. Okay, see here our second problem is ABCD is a parallelogram. If the two diagonals are equal, find the measure of angle ABC. Find the measure of angle ABC. We have to find out angle ABC. This measurement we have to find out. Before that, what is given? See, if the two diagonals are equal, this is given. Okay, so that I am taking here given things ABCD. First, given ABCD is a parallelogram. That they have told us. Okay, so we will use properties of parallelogram here. Then second thing they have told us, DB is equals to AC. Diagonals are equal. So DB and AC are the diagonals of this parallelogram. So both are equal. Understood? Then what we have to prove? Find the measure of angle ABC. Measure of angle ABC. ABC we have to find out. Okay. So now ABC we need to find out. Before that, they have told us ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. So in proof, ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. If ABCD is a parallelogram, then definitely opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal in length, so equal and parallel. So here we can say AD is equal to CB. AD and CB are a pair of opposite side, as well as AB and CD. AB is equal to CD. Okay. Why? Opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram are always equal. Understood? So now we can take triangle DAB and triangle CBA. Triangle DAB we are going to use. In triangle DAB and triangle CBA, DAB and CBA, what is DA is equal to CB? Okay, DA, here we will say this is first one and this is second one. So DA or AD is equal to CB. AD and CB are the sides of the corresponding triangles. So here we can see from 1, because opposite side of parallelogram. Then second thing we can take, DB is equal to AC. DB is equal to AC. Okay. DB is equal to AC. DB and AC are equal. Why? Because they have told us diagonals are equal. They have given us. So here we can write given. Okay. And AB is the common side. AB is the common side for both the triangles. So we can take AB is equal to AB, which is common side. So with the help of side criteria, we can say triangle DAB congruent triangle CBA by SSS criteria. Okay, now both the triangles are congruent by SSS criteria. We have given here proof. Okay, now we can see here one thing we know that is AD and BC are parallel because ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so here we can mention that AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. So AB will work as a transversal. So AB is a transversal. Okay. One thing here, if triangle DAB and CBA are equal, then we can say D DAB is equal to CBA. Okay, with the help of this, if both the triangles are congruent, then I can say here that I am taking here now angle DAB is equal to angle CBA by CPCT. Okay, if both the triangles are congruent, angles are same by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, so this I am saying this is third one. This is I am saying third one. Okay, angles are equal. This angle and this angle is equal. Okay, after that we are thinking about this. AD is parallel to BC. If AD is parallel to BC, AB is a transversal. Okay, AB is a transversal. So definitely we can say DAB plus CBA is equal to 180 degree, because these two angles, the sum of this will be 180 degree, that we have seen already. Okay, so here I am taking AB is a transversal. So finally DAB plus CBA, angle CBA is equal to 180 degree. Sum of both the angles is 180 degree, this and this. Okay, so now here DAB and CBA are same. DAB and CBA are same. CBA means what? ABC. CBA means angle ABC. Okay, they are asking angle ABC, but both the angles are same. So instead of that I am taking that angle CBA. Instead of this, I am taking this CBA plus angle CBA is equal to 180 degree. So CBA plus CBA is equal to 2 times angle CBA is equal to 180. So CBA I am taking now ABC is equal to 180 divided by 2. So it will be 90 degree. So angle ABC is 90 degree. Okay. So with the help of SSS criteria, we have given proof. Two triangles are congruent, then parallel sides are there. So AB is a transversal we have taken. Okay, actually CD is also a transversal, but we have taken AB because we have to find out angle B. Okay, so now so angles are supplementary, so sum we have taken, but both the angles are same, so we have replaced DAB by CBA. Both angles are same, so 2 times CBA is equal to 180, so angle ABC is equal to 180 divided by 2, that is 90 degree, and they are asking angle ABC is 90 degree. Okay, thank you.